Hey, what's up guys? So today I wanted to show you how to retouch your own photos using Adobe Photoshop. I have an image here that was taken in the studio. In this image, I wasn't wearing any makeup and you can see my skin is looking a little harsh. A couple of pimples here and there, a couple of blemishes, you know, a little bit of shine and greasiness. And you know, it's not a flattering look. I mean, you're not gonna put this on a comp card or present this to an agent or a client. So definitely want to touch this up and make it look more presentable. So the first thing I like to do is I like to duplicate the layer. So I'm on a Mac and the keyboard shortcut for duplicating the layer is Command J. So with the first layer selected, I am going to call that low frequency and call the second layer high frequency. So now I'm going to select the low frequency layer and I am going to go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so I can see what's going on and see what the face is looking like. So now with this filter Gaussian Blur, the trick is, it's not really about the number or the radius, so don't really pay attention to this number. What you want to do is you want to make the picture blurry, but not extremely blurry, just very slightly blurry where it looks like it's out of focus. So in this case, I'm just going to go to about here. Now with the high frequency layer selected, what you want to do is go to image and then go to apply image. So now that you have this box popped up, what you want to do is that you want to select the layer and say low frequency layer, and then you want to subtract. So now this is the scale is set at a 2, the offset is set at a 128, and that's usually standard, so just leave that, don't touch that. So you hit OK, and then still on the high frequency layer, what you do is you come to linear light. Okay. So now it looks like nothing has happened, and that's because nothing has happened. So go back to your low frequency layer and come into your lasso tool. Then you can zoom into the picture, make it a little bit bigger, and let's start working on the forehead. That's usually the first place I like to start working at. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a lasso around some of the areas of the forehead with rough texture. And try to avoid the hair because you want to keep the hair nice and sharp. You don't really need to texturize the hair, if you will. So then what you want to do is come to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur again. But this time, try to play with it and see what looks good. So as you can see, as I increase the radius, my forehead gets a much smoother texture, but then you don't want to go too much because then it starts to look dark and kind of grainy or, you know, glitchy. So what you want to do is we want to find a good middle ground where you still have some texture and you still have some of the highlights from the flash that was hitting my face. So in this case, if I come down to like a 5, that's not good because you can still see all the rough texture in the skin. So you're going to come to about, I'll say probably about a 30. And then hit the deselect the lasso. So now, don't worry too much about these little pimples that you can see here because you can easily take care of that after this texturizing step has been done. So now, next I'm going to take care of this cheek on the right. Draw a lasso around that. You can see the texture is a little bit rough. Go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, still a 30. I guess a 30 also looks good for this. So I'm gonna hit OK. Hit this deselect. Then I'm going to, the left side of my face looks good, but I'm still going to work on the texture a little bit just to make it a little bit more smoother. Then I go to Filter, Blur again, Gaussian Blur. 30 looks good. See what happens if we decrease or increase. That's a little bit too much. So I'll say, yeah, about a 30.3 looks good. I hit deselect. So as you can see, the texture on my skin is much improved from what it was. Again, if you're on a Mac, you can hit the option and click on this eyeball on the first layer, so that way you can get a before and after of what the image looks like. So you can see this is rough and it's a little bit better. Okay, so now let's work on the neck area. So now, and then come to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and you still want to maintain the highlights. You don't want to over retouch the picture and lose all the highlights and the details in the image. So just hit okay, deselect again, and maybe the chest area could use a little bit of work. You can see there's some hair, some chest hair there. There's a little bit of bump, filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's look, let's see. That's gonna be too smooth, so keep that up there. Okay, so now when we zoom out, you can see already that the image is looking a lot better than it did before we started. Okay, so now to actually start getting rid of some of the blemishes and some of the pimples, what you wanna do is click on the high frequency layer and then come to your spot healing brush and just start brushing over. So for instance, and then you wanna make sure you have a really good brush size. In this case, this brush size is way too big, so I need to decrease that just a little bit. So I'm gonna, yeah, that looks about good. So about 69 looks good to me. And then you can just start clicking and it's just like magic, it goes away. If only real life was like this, right? Okay, so now that I've gone through the image and taken away some of the pimples that was kind of bothering me, you can see that we're having a much better image than we did when we started. So the next step I like to do is I like to go in and create a separate layer, call this layer Enhance. Now with this layer, I would change the blend mode to soft light. Now with this layer selected, what I like to do is I like to get a brush. So now with the brush, what I do is that I take a white, I change the color to white, and anywhere I see a highlight or anywhere I like to create a highlight, like for example, enhancing the cheekbones, you can just go ahead and spray or brush over it. You can just go ahead and brush over that area. So for instance, I like to do the T-zone area. Oh, and another thing with the brush is that you want to make sure that your opacity is really low. So in this case, I like to bring it to like a 25. And then I'll just brush over the T-zone area. And also the cheekbones. And then you can narrow the brush. And brush ever so slightly over the nose. Some on the chin. And then what I like to do next is to do the opposites. So I would create a black brush stroke and do the same underneath. Oops. And I'll increase this a little bit and just do the same underneath. Some of the cheekbone areas, and just do the same underneath some of the cheekbone areas. So that would make the cheekbone pop out just a little bit more. And then on the sides of the nose. And then, so now you can see that this looks a little bit extreme. So the only thing you have to do
is to decrease the opacity of the enhanced layer that you created. So I'm just going to do this. I'm going to decrease it to about maybe a 41. That looks about good. So now let's toggle this on and off and see what that's looking like. So without, and this is the enhanced. So you can see with the enhanced, you have the cheekbones looks a lot more enhanced, looks more detailed. You can see the highlights, and that's a much better look than what you had before without the enhanced layer. So there you have it, guys. This is just a simple way to quickly retouch your pictures by yourself without needing a professional photographer's help. This could save you a lot of time, it could save you a lot of money, and this is always good to know because you can use it in other areas. So there you go, guys. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments below. I have tons of other tips that I will be talking about in the future, so stay tuned.